Exodus chapter 4. Then Moses answered, "But behold, they will not believe me or listen to my voice, for they will say, 'The Lord did not appear to you.'" The Lord said to him, "What is that in your hand?" He said, "A staff." And he said, "Throw it on the ground." So he threw it on the ground, and it became a serpent, and Moses ran from it. But the Lord said to Moses, "Put out your hand and catch it by the tail." So he put out his hand and caught it, and it became a staff in his hand, that they may believe that the Lord God, the God of their fathers, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob has appeared to you. Again the Lord said to him, "Put your hand inside your cloak." And he put his hand inside his cloak, and when he took it out, behold, his hand was leprous like snow. Then God said, "Put your hand back inside your cloak." So he put his hand back inside his cloak, and when he took it out, behold, it was restored like the rest of his flesh. "If they will not believe you," God said, "or listen to the first sign, they may believe the latter sign. If they will not believe even these two signs or listen to your voice, you shall take some water from the Nile and pour it on the dry ground. And the water that you shall take from the Nile will become blood on the dry ground." But Moses said to the Lord, "Oh my Lord, I am not eloquent, either in the past or since you have spoken to your servant, but I am slow of speech and tongue." Then the Lord said to him, "Who has made man's mouth? Who makes him mute or deaf or seeing or blind? Is it not I, the Lord? Now therefore, go, and I will be with your mouth and teach you what you shall speak." But he said, "Oh my Lord, please send someone else." Then the anger of the Lord was kindled against Moses, and he said, "Is there not Aaron your brother, the Levite? I know that he can speak well. Behold, he is coming out to meet you, and when he sees you, he will be glad in his heart. You shall speak to him and put the words in his mouth, and I will be with your mouth and with his mouth, and will teach you both what to do. He shall speak for you to the people, and he shall be your mouth, and you shall be as God to him. And take in your hand this staff, with which you shall do the signs." Moses went back to Jethro, his father-in-law, and said to him, "Please, let me go back to my brothers in Egypt, to see whether they are still alive." And Jethro said to Moses, "Go in peace." And the Lord said to Moses in Midian, "Go back to Egypt, for all the men who were seeking your life are dead." So Moses took his wife and his sons and had them ride on a donkey and went back to the land of Egypt. And Moses took the staff of God in his hand. The Lord said to Moses, "When you return to Egypt, see that you perform before Pharaoh all the wonders I have given you the power to do. But I will harden his heart so that he will not let the people go. Then say to Pharaoh, 'This is what the Lord says, Israel is my firstborn son, and I told him, let my son go so he may worship me. But you refused to let him go, so I will kill your firstborn son.'" At a lodging place on the way, the Lord met Moses and was about to kill him. But Zipporah took a flint knife, cut off her son's foreskin, and touched Moses' feet with it. "Surely you are a bridegroom of blood to me," she said. So the Lord let him alone. At that time, she said, "bridegroom of blood," referring to circumcision. The Lord said to Aaron, "Go into the wilderness to meet Moses." So he met Moses at the mountain of God and kissed him. Then Moses told Aaron everything the Lord had sent him to say, and also about all the signs he had commanded him to perform. Moses and Aaron brought together all the elders of the Israelites, and Aaron told them everything the Lord had said to Moses. He also performed the signs before the people, and they believed. And when they heard that the Lord was concerned about them and had seen their misery, they bowed down and worshipped. Chapter 5. Afterward, Moses and Aaron went to Pharaoh and said, "This is what the Lord, the God of Israel, says. Let my people go, so that they may hold a festival to me in the wilderness." Pharaoh said, "Who is the Lord, that I should obey him and let Israel go? I do not know the Lord, and I will not let Israel go." Then they said, "The God of the Hebrews has met with us. Now, let us take a 3-day journey into the wilderness to offer sacrifices to the Lord our God, or he may strike us with plagues or with the sword." But the king of Egypt said, "Moses and Aaron, why are you taking the people away from their labor? Get back to work." Then Pharaoh said, "Look, the people of the land are now numerous, and you are stopping them from working." That same day, Pharaoh gave this order to the slave drivers and overseers in charge of the people. "You are no longer to supply the people with straw for making bricks. Let them go and gather their own straw, but require them to make the same number of bricks as before. Don't reduce the quota. They are lazy. That is why they are crying out, 'Let us go and sacrifice to our God.' Make the work harder for the people, so that they keep working and pay no attention to lies." Then the slave drivers and the overseers went out and said to the people, "This is what Pharaoh says, 'I will not give you any more straw. Go and get your own straw wherever you can find it, but your work will not be reduced at all.'" So the people scattered through all the land of Egypt to gather stubble for straw, and the taskmasters pressed them, saying, "Complete your work quota, your daily amount, just as when you had straw." Moreover, the foremen of the sons of Israel, whom Pharaoh's taskmasters had set over them, were beaten and asked, "Why have you not completed your required task of making bricks, either yesterday or today, as before?" Then the foremen of the sons of Israel came and cried out to Pharaoh, saying, "Why do you deal this way with your servants? There is no straw given to your servants, yet they keep saying to us, 'Make bricks.' And behold, your servants are being beaten, but it is the fault of your own people." But he said, "You are lazy, very lazy. For that reason you say, 'Let us go and sacrifice to the Lord.' So go now and work, for you will be given no straw, but you must deliver the quota of bricks." The foremen of the sons of Israel saw that they were in trouble, since they were told, "You must not reduce your daily amount of bricks." When they left Pharaoh's presence, they met Moses and Aaron as they were waiting for them, and they said to them, "May the Lord look upon you and judge you, because you have made us repulsive in Pharaoh's sight and in the sight of his servants, to put a sword in their hand to kill us." Then Moses returned to the Lord and said, "Lord, why have you brought harm to this people? Why did you ever send me? Ever since I came to Pharaoh to speak in your name, he has done harm to his people, and you have not rescued your people at all." Chapter 6. Then the Lord said to Moses, "Now you shall see what I will do to Pharaoh. For under compulsion, he will let them go, and under compulsion, he will drive them out of his land." God spoke further to Moses and said to him, "I am the Lord, and I appeared to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob as God Almighty. But by my name, Lord, I did not make myself known to them. I also established my covenant with them to give them the land of Canaan, the land in which they lived as strangers. Furthermore, I have heard the groaning of the sons of Israel, because the Egyptians are holding them in bondage, and I have remembered my covenant. Say therefore to the sons of Israel, I am the Lord, and I will bring you out from under the labors of the Egyptians, and I will rescue you from their bondage. I will also redeem you with an outstretched arm and with great judgments. Then I will take you as my people, and I will be your God. And you shall know that I am the Lord your God, who brought you out from under the labors of the Egyptians. I will bring you to the land which I swore to give Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and I will give it to you as a possession. I am the Lord. So Moses said to the sons of Israel, but they did not listen to Moses on account of their despondency and cruel bondage. Now the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, go, tell Pharaoh king of Egypt to let the sons of Israel go out of his land. But Moses spoke before the Lord, saying, behold, the sons of Israel have not listened to me. How then will Pharaoh listen to me, as I am unskilled in speech? Nevertheless, the Lord spoke to Moses and to Aaron, and gave them a command concerning the sons of Israel and Pharaoh king of Egypt, to bring the sons of Israel out of the land of Egypt. These are the heads of their fathers' households: the sons of Reuben, Israel's firstborn, Hanok and Palu, Hezron and Carmi. These are the families of Reuben. And the sons of Simeon, Jemuel, Jamin, Ohad, Jachin, Zohar, and Shaul, the son of a Canaanite woman. These are the families of Simeon. And these are the names of the sons of Levi, according to their generations: Gershon, Kohath, and Merari. And the length of Levi's life was 137 years. The sons of Gershon, Libni and Shimei, according to their families. And the sons of Kohath, Amram, Izhar, Hebron, and Uziel. And the length of Kohath's life was 133 years. And the sons of Merari, Mahli, and Mushi. These are the families of the Levites, according to their generations. Now Amram married his father's sister, Jochebed, and she bore him Aaron and Moses, and the length of Amram's life was 137 years. And the sons of Izhar, Korah, Nepheg, and Zikri, and the sons of Uziel, Mishael, Elzaphan, and Sithri. Aaron married Elisheba, the daughter of Amminadab, the sister of Nashon, and she bore him Nadab and Abihu, Eleazar and Ithamar. And the sons of Korah, Asir, Elkanah, and Abiasaph. These are the families of the Korahites. Now Aaron's son Eleazar married one of the daughters of Putiel, and she bore him Phinehas. And these are the heads of the fathers' households of the Levites, according to their families. It was the same Aaron and Moses to whom the Lord said, bring out the sons of Israel from the land of Egypt according to their multitudes. They were the ones who spoke to Pharaoh, king of Egypt, about bringing out the sons of Israel from Egypt. It was the same Moses and Aaron. When the Lord spoke to Moses in the land of Egypt, he said to him, I am the Lord. Tell Pharaoh, the king of Egypt, everything I am telling you. But Moses argued with the Lord, saying, I can't do it. I'm such a clumsy speaker. Why should Pharaoh listen to me?